Hello dear viewer, today I want to explain how to set up active thruster throttling on our spaceships. I won't go into thruster performance charts or discuss when and when not to use thruster throttling, because I will release a video dedicated to that question soon. So without further ado, let's jump right into the technical setup. Here's the situation. This is a modified version of Boxcar, an early game spaceship I made a video about a couple days ago. It has three normal thrusters, which can consume a maximum of 360 fuel per second. But the chemical plants only produce 37.5 fuel per second. We are heavily underproducing, but while sitting in orbit, we can fill these storage tanks to have additional fuel on each trip. Instead of burning the extra fuel quickly at maximum thrust and bad efficiency, we want to actively throttle them so that they consume only 120 fuel per second combined, and are able to provide a strong thrust longer. A normal pump in Factorio moves 1200 liquid per second, and there's no way to reduce the pumping rate to 120. But what we can do is open and close or activate and deactivate the pump in such a way that it will on average pump the desired 120 per second. In order to do that, we need to set up a counter with circuit logic. This is very easy, trust me. All we need is one constant combinator and one decider combinator. Open the constant combinator and set a signal with value 1. It doesn't matter which signal, I choose the circle signal. Now we connect the constant combinator to the decider combinator's input. Open the decider combinator, which has an input signal of circle with value 1. We now compare this signal to a threshold, like for example 22. If this comparison is true, the combinator should output the same signal and value from its input. So we choose the circle signal again and check input count. Because 1 is lower than 22, the combinator outputs the same signal with the same value, circle 1. Now comes the crucial part. We connect the output of the decider combinator to its own input. It's like magic, isn't it? We created a counter constantly counting to 22 in a recurring way. But why does it work? The combinator now sees two values in its input. One from the constant combinator and one from its own output. Both are summed within the combinator, creating a higher number on each tick. What is a tick? The game is calculated and rendered at a speed of 60 ticks per second. But why isn't this creating a short circuit or infinite loop crashing the game? That's because the output of combinators is delayed by one tick, and therefore the result is only available for further processing the following tick. You can verify this in the editor, where we can stop time and go forward tick by tick. On the first tick we examine, the input value is 1, and 1 is lower than 22. But there's no output, because the output will only be available the next tick. So let's move one tick forward. Now our input is 2. It's the sum of the constant combinator and the output, which is now 1, the result from the previous tick. 2 is lower than 22, so the new output will be circle 2, but again, this value appears delayed on the next tick. This is the third tick we examine. Input is now 3, the sum of the constant combinator, which always outputs value 1, and value 2, the result from the previous tick. And this process repeats itself, increasing the value of our signal by 1 every tick, until we reach the threshold of 22 on the 22nd tick. Because 22 is not lower than 22, we output nothing. The next tick, tick number 23, our input is only 1 from the constant combinator, resetting the count. We can now use this counter to activate and deactivate entities like pumps or lamps. I will use an additional lamp just so that it's easier to see what's going on. We set the pump to only activate when the signal is lower than 12, and we copy this behavior to the lamp. As you can see, the pump and lamp is now only active for 11 ticks and then disabled for the next 11 ticks, until our counter resets its count back to 1. 11 out of 22 ticks, that's half, so if the pump is deactivated half of the time, it only pumps half of the 1200 liquid per second, which is 600. But we wanted to supply our thrusters with 120 per second, not 600. So all we have to do is change the threshold of our comparison in the decider combinator and the threshold of our pump. 120 out of 1,200 is what we need, and the quotient of 1,200 divided by 120 is 10. So, in order to get the desired flow of 120 per second, we only want to open the pump for one tick every 10 ticks. Set the combinator threshold to compare with lower than 10, and the threshold in the pump to be lower than 2. You can't see my finger press the next tick button, but trust me. On this tick, the lamp is on and I press 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times until it's on again for one tick. Let's build the same setup on our spaceship and connect everything. Boom, we are off heading towards Vulcanus, and initially the thrusters are at full thrust. That's because there's a fuel buffer in the pipes behind the pump and also inside the thrusters. But as you can see, after a while, fuel consumption falls to 40 per second on each thruster. Exactly what we wanted. 85% efficiency. Let's remove all waiting conditions and continue towards Gleba. The fluid statistics reveal we are consuming 7,200 fuel per minute, which is, you guessed it, 120 per second. Perfect. Let's add some more useful logic to our thruster throttling. Since Factorio 2.0, you can add multiple conditions in a single decider combinator. This allows us to connect the fuel tanks to the combinator and additionally read and compare their status as well. With a slightly more complicated set of conditions, we set a threshold of 20k for fuel and oxidizer. Now our thruster throttling only becomes active when the amount of liquid in any of the tanks falls below 20k. If our ship is able to fill both storage tanks fully, we can now fly with full power longer, but we still throttle down eventually. Here we are going to Vulcanus, and now the throttling kicks in. There's still some buffer in the pipes, but we are now losing some power and gain efficiency. If we don't stay in Vulcanus' orbit and head off to Gleba instantly, throttling is active immediately, because we were below 20k in both tanks from the start. This also means if you start producing more fuel in the future, because you increase quality of chemical plants and or modules, throttling will automatically be disabled for longer and longer on each journey, and maybe even become permanently disabled because of overproduction. But in case of a hiccup or problem, it's still there as a safeguard. And while editing this video, I realized we don't even need the constant combinator, because since Factorio 2.0, you can add an additional output signal in the decider combinator. But with a constant combinator, it's easier to see and understand what the hell is going on, so I'm glad I used it while recording. Okay, I hope this guide was helpful, and I will add a blueprint in the description below if you don't want to set this up yourself. Please consider subscribing if you didn't already. Thanks, bye.